हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम प्रोफेसर श्रद्धा शेके फ्रॉम के वाघ इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग। दिस इज़ अवर थर्ड लेक्चर ऑन द टॉपिक डिजिटल लॉजिक फैमिलीज। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल टॉक अबाउट TTL लॉजिक सर्किट और TTL लॉजिक फैमिली। ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ दिस लेक्चर आर ऑपरेशन ऑफ द TTL NAND गेट। We will be discussing about two input TTL NAND gate, its circuit and its operation. Active pull up. What is the concept of the active pull up and the wire ending? TTL NAND gate IC. Dual in line package, that is DIP package, is the most common pin, most common package for the ICs. Almost many of the times we have observed first this IC, the first diagram, in our laboratories we have used that. Second diagram is its internal structure, its pin configuration. There are four NAND gates present in this IC 7400. Up till now we are saying that logic gates are the basic building blocks of the digital electronics and the digital circuits. But have you ever thought about what is there inside that logic gate? So inside the logic gates, there are, based on the logic families which we have discussed in previous lecture, that is TTL or maybe ECL or CMOS or Schottky TTL or RTL. So based on these logic families, we are having transistors, resistors, transistor resistors, then diodes or MOSFETs are present inside that. So today we will be discussing about what is there in this NAND gate, one NAND gate, if you are using TTL logic family, its internal circuit. Two input TTL NAND gate, this is the internal circuit of the two input TTL NAND gate. If you observe the diagram, in which second diagram, there is a transistor Q1 having two inputs A and B, and the output is there. So in the previous diagram, that means this one, the NAND gate 1, let us consider the first NAND gate, which is present in the input terminals 1, 2 and the output terminal at 3. Inside that, for the TTL logic family, we are having this diagram. We have to discuss about its operation. This circuit consists of the four transistors Q1, Q2, Q3 and Q4 and one diode, some resistors are also there. If you observe the Q3, this diode D1 and Q4, this arrangement is called as totem pole. We will talk about the advantages of this afterwards. First, let us focus on the transistor Q1. This is a multiple emitter transistor. Multiple emitter transistor will have the two more than one input emitter terminal. This transistor is having two input terminal, emitter terminal. You know, a transistor BJT, if you draw the equivalent circuit of the BJT, this is like your diode, two diode circuits. So this transistor, if you observe, is a NPN transistor, and in the red box it is shown diode equivalent of the Q1, the circuit which is shown, diode equivalent circuit of the transistor Q1. So if you observe, the base terminal and the emitter terminal of the transistor Q1, base terminal and the input terminal A, that can be replaced by the diode D2. And base terminal and the input terminal B can be replaced by the diode D3. base and the collector terminal can be replaced by the diode D4. So this is the electrical equivalent circuit, you can say, of this transistor Q1. Then there is a transistor Q2. Task of the Q2, basically it is a switching circuit, you can say. The task, what Q2 will do, it will on Q3 and at the same time it will off Q4, or it may off Q3 and at the same time it may on Q4. We will discuss that afterwards. Diode D1 ensures when Q1 is on, Q3 is off, Q3 is off. So, task of the diode D1 is to, in the totem poles arrangement, is to ensure that Q3 and Q4 should never be on at the same instant of time. When Q3 is on, Q4 should be off, and when Q3 is off, Q4 should be on. If we don't use this diode, there is possibility that both the transistors are on at the same instant of time. We are talking about what is the need of totem pole in this circuit. So, for that discussion, let us consider the circuit without totem pole. So, a NAND gate can be constructed without the totem pole, that is without the transistor Q3 and diode D1, which is shown in this diagram. So, I will show you one more diagram in the second slide, next slide. Observe here. This is a TTL NAND with the passive pull up circuit, in which the transistor Q3 and the diode D from the totem pole shown in the previous diagram is removed. And neglect about this transistor Q1, this is the 3 input terminal transistor Q1. The same diagram is applicable for the 2 input terminal also. So, time being, neglect the transistor Q1. Observe here, this is called as a passive pull up. Passive pull up means the resistor which is shown as a 4K resistor, let us call that resistor as a R. And that resistor is acting as a pull-up resistor over here. And the 1K resistor, which is connected at the emitter terminal of the transistor Q2, is called as a RE resistor. And that resistor is acting as a pull-down resistor from the pull-down resistor, because it is useful, or it is giving the zero, or it is useful for giving the sufficient voltage for the transistor Q3. Now, our aim is to discuss about what is the need of totem pole and what was the problem in the passive pull up. If you connect only R over there, which is if you connect only R as a resistor, which is shown in this diagram as a 4K resistor, if you use only this circuit, then what is the problem in this circuit? So, VO is the output voltage. If you connect other logic gates to the input of this logic gate, to the output of this logic gate, that means if you are having a circuit, multiple logic gates are connected at the output of this logic gate, then that other logic gates will act as a load for this logic gate. So, the load of this logic gate, or load of any logic gate, can have the two components, or impedance, output impedance can have the two components, resistive impedance as well as the capacitive impedance. Capacitive impedance, or the capacitive load, is formed by using the output capacitance of this transistor, which is connected at the output terminal of this gate, plus fan out of the fan out gates are also there, because you are connecting this output to the other gates also. So, the input capacitance of this fan out gates plus the wiring stray capacitance. So, by addition of all these capacitances, there is a capacitive components, or capacitive impedance is also present in the load. So, capacitive impedance is there. Now, when the transistor Q3 is off, then what will happen? If transistor Q3 is off in this diagram, that capacitive load will get charged through this 4K resistors, right? And the time constant, let us say the 4K resistor is denoted by R and the capacitive load is C, then the time constant is RC. So, if we have to reduce that time constant, we have to reduce the value of R. this is the first case. So our requirement, first requirement is that the value of R should be low. But when T is on, when this transistor Q3 is on, then what will happen? If the transistor Q3 is on, then our requirement is that value of R should be high, because what will happen if value of this resistor R is low? Then the large current will flow through this capacitor, through this collector of this transistor Q3. Whenever transistor T is on and value of R is low, the large current IC, collector current, will flow through the transistor Q3, and that may increase the IC saturation current. And if IC saturation is increased, we have to apply more base current. So our requirement is that we want low value of R when T is off, and we want higher value of R when T is on. And these two are contradictory statements. So that's why we require a circuit which will give the lower value of R when T is off, and higher value of R when T is on. And this condition is satisfied by using this totem pole output. And that's why the need of totem pole output, and totem pole, that is transistor Q3, is called as active pull-up. So this is the concept of active pull-up. Now, the truth table and the working of this two input TTL NAND gate with the totem pole output. The truth table of NAND gate is, when both inputs are 1, 1, output should be 0. And the otherwise output should be 1. Let us see how that condition is satisfied. When both the inputs are 0, 0, then when one or both the inputs are low, connected to the ground, you will observe, as I have shown you the equivalent circuit, there are two diodes. If both are 0, 0, these two diodes will act as a forward bias. I will go to the previous slide. Yes, these two diodes, diode D2 and D3, shown in this diagram, if you connect both A and B to the ground, these two diodes will act as a forward bias, and the current will pass through the ground through this R1. We are discussing the condition truth table of this NAND gate. So when both or any one of the input is low, connected to the ground, base emitter junction of the transistor Q1 is forward bias. So transistor Q1 is on, saturated, and the output at the collector will be low, making Q2 off. See, observe this diagram. When Q2 transistor will be off, if there is sufficient base current provided by the transistor Q1 to turn on the Q2. But if you connect both A and B to the grounded, the current will flow through the emitter terminals of the Q1, right, and the voltage at the base and the collector of the Q1 plus the voltage at the R3, which is shown in this diagram, is not sufficient to turn on this transistor Q2. So Q2 is off, right? Q2 is off. That means its emitter is not able to provide the sufficient base current to transistor Q4. So whenever Q2 is off, Q4 will also off. And coming towards the collector of Q2. So Q2 is off means, let us say Q2 is open switch, then all the current through the resistor R2 will be provided to the base of the transistor Q3, and Q3 will be on. So as I told you, the Q2 is acted as a switching transistor. Its task is to turn on the Q3 and at the same time it will off the Q4 or the other case, opposite case. So now at the output Q3 is on and Q4 is off. So Q4 is open switch and Q3 is closed switch. So you will observe the current will be flowing through R4, Q3 and this D1 and the output will be 1. So how will you calculate the output? For the first case, the output will be equals to VCC minus R4 into, let us say the current is IC, so R4 into IC and the voltage drop across the collector and the emitter of the transistor Q3, that is VCE of Q3 and the forward voltage drop across the diode D1, that is 0.7 volt and which is as good as logic 1. So this is how, whenever both the inputs are 0 or any one of the input is connected to the ground, you will get the output as 1. Let us talk about the last case when both the transistors are when both the inputs are 1 1. So observe the diagram, second diagram, in which both the inputs are connected to VCC. So the diodes will be reverse biased, they are not conducting and the current will be flowing through the Q1, like a diode which is equivalent to the base and the collector of the Q1 will be forward biased and the it will be providing the sufficient voltage across the or sufficient base current to turn on the Q2. So Q2 is on and the Q4 is also on, because Q2 is on, so emitter collector of the Q2 will provide the sufficient base current for Q4 to turn on. So Q2 on and Q4 on, and Q3 is off because the base current provided at the Q3 is not sufficient to turn on the Q3. So Q3 is off. So your circuit will be like Q3 is open switch and you are measuring the voltage across this closed switch or the short circuit, because Q4 is as good as closed switch and that is equals to 0. So this is how your circuit will be working. What are the features of the totem pole output? Low power consumption. One of the advantages, low power consumption, fast switching, low output impedance, external pull-up is not required. But disadvantages are that output of the two gates cannot be tied together. Okay, this is one disadvantage of the totem pole output. What is basically the ending and what is that disadvantage that we have discussed on previous slide? If the outputs of the two TTL gates are tied together, then the logic performed is AND, as shown in this diagram. If you directly connect the two outputs, then it is called as a wire ending. So what if the totem pole outputs are tied together? Observe this diagram. This is only the output stage of the two different logic gates. So on the left side of this first circuit is the transistor Q1. Then Q2, right now we have discussed. On the right side of this second transistor, circuit is again the one more circuit. So we have drawn only the output stages of the two NAND gates. So just imagine that there are two NAND gates and you are shorting or you are joining the outputs of two NAND gates together at the point X in this diagram. So what will happen if the TTL gates with the totem pole outputs have their outputs tied together? Then gates may be destroyed. How, that we will discuss. Okay, if the left gate has a high output and the right gate has a low output. So right now we have discussed, whenever the output is high, that is 1, the transistor Q3 is on and Q4 is off, and the whenever output is 0, then the transistor Q3 is off and transistor Q4 is on. So we will observe in this diagram. So first gate A and second gate is B, for example. So Q3 A is on and Q4 B is on. So large current will flow from transistor Q3 to Q4, and this may damage the transistors. So totem pole outputs tied together can produce the harmful current through Q3 and Q4B. Same condition is applied for Q3B and Q4A when the output conditions are opposite. So this is the disadvantage of the totem pole. So wire ending is not possible in the totem pole. Two more points about this are that unconnected inputs. So unconnected inputs means the inputs which are not connected to anything. So that inputs will be acting as a logic 1 in case of TTL, because they are as good as the diodes D1 and D2 are open circuits. And one more thing, we can connect two external diodes at terminal A and ground, and at terminal B and ground, to protect the transistor from an unwanted negative voltages. So these diodes can be connected and they called as a protective diodes. So that's it. So in this lecture we have discussed about the totem pole, two input TTL NAND gate with the totem pole. What is the concept of active and passive pull up resistors? What is the need what is the need of that, and its working. Also, one disadvantage of totem pole is that wire ending is not possible. So how to overcome that disadvantage? By using the open collector TTL NAND gate. So in next video we will be talking about that. Thank you.